We'll leave it to the Halloween capital of the world to have a giant jack-o'-lantern roundabout. The painted pumpkin has been in Anoka since 2017. But if you think you're noticing more roundabouts in Minnesota in general, you are correct. Those traffic circles have been popping up everywhere, from congested traffic areas to rural roads.
So we wanted to know why and how do you use them the right way? Rena Sargentopoulos went to find out.
Your eyes and wheels do not deceive you. You're seeing more circles.
Just recently, there's been kind of almost a cascade of more roundabouts every single year.
MnDOT's first roundabouts went in 2002 down in Medford off of I-35. According to a national roundabout database, yes, there is such a thing, Minnesota now has 498. And the reason behind the rise has nothing to do with trying to annoy you.
The biggest thing when we've looked at the research is really we see this really big reduction in fatal and serious injury crashes. So after we install a roundabout, we typically see an 80 to 90% reduction in fatal and serious injury crashes versus the before conditions.
MnDOT says they're up to 70% safer for pedestrians too. But how?
Well, by design, they force drivers to slow down, and they take out those right angles that a four-way stop or signaled intersection have, both things that make crashes far more severe. Plus, the design of the crosswalks makes it safer for pedestrians who now only have to cross one lane of traffic at a time. And the suburbs, well, they must have been reading those very same studies.
We have six full-size or standard-size roundabouts in Edina, and we have four what we call mini roundabouts.
For Edina, the reasons weren't strictly about safety. They say roundabouts help move traffic through congested intersections better. So they've put in a few near schools.
Eventually they learned that it is better for me to be able to just yield and go through these from a traffic operations standpoint than having a four-way stop that was here before. You'd have cars backed all the way up to Vernon Avenue in each direction during these school pickup and drop-off times.
But let's just admit that change is hard, and for most of us, when we learned to drive, roundabouts weren't, well, around.
Usually when you put one in, the first few weeks, you get the calls like, why did you do it? I don't like the size of this one. Can you do something different? I don't know how to operate it.
That's changing too. According to Minnesota's Department of Public Safety, roundabouts are covered in the driver's manual for new drivers. And there are a few locations around the state that have roundabouts on the road test. DPS says as more roundabouts are built, they'll likely expand the testing. But for the rest of us, maybe a quick lesson would be helpful.
You always yield to the person that's already in the circle.
Andrew Plowman knows of what he speaks. He has designed more than his fair share of roundabouts over the years, from minis to urban compact, single lane to multi-lane too. But no matter the size, they all work the same.
Now, when there's a gap in traffic, they would then enter, proceed to wherever their destination is, and then exit, and then as they're exiting, look for a pedestrian in the crossing.
It's that simple. Slow down, yield to the cars already in the circle, turn right, proceed to your exit, and exit. When you approach a two-lane roundabout, same concept. From the right lane, you can turn right at the first exit or go straight. Use the inside or left lane to go straight, or if you're going all the way around to the last exit, as if you were making a left-hand turn at a traditional intersection. The signage helps make it clear. But do you need to use your turn signal? Andrew says it is a big debate in the roundabout industry, but here in Minnesota, according to our statutes, the answer is no. The distance between where you enter and exit is so short, it doesn't really matter.
Now, number one, even when I'm sitting at a regular intersection, I don't necessarily trust somebody's signal. Number two, it is fractions of a second before you're going to know that they're actually turning or they're exiting.
While it may be the case that many drivers are not familiar with roundabout rules, they still seem to be working. And they're kind of growing on people, mostly, maybe. Well, anyway, get used to them because they're sticking around.
Roundabouts, they're not a fad anymore, and they're pretty much here to stay.
Rena Sargentopoulos, KIR 11 News.
Andrew tells us that they have found single-lane roundabouts have fewer accidents than double-lane ones. While they're not serious accidents, in an effort to reduce them, they have started choosing the single-lane option more often and have condensed some two lanes down to one. And
super
there you
interesting.
Go.
80 to 90% reduction in serious crashes is a lot.
I mean, the key is, I think when we first started seeing them where they just were like small little pods in the middle of the roads, it was just to slow people down. But now, I mean, they are popping up.
Belle doesn't like to be slowed down, ladies and gentlemen. She does not like to be slowed down.
Go around things. No, I think it's interesting. But I think love or hate, that's kind of.